So let's create a Zippy directive, which will combine some of the concepts we've learned so far, and also maybe stretch ourselves a little bit by throwing in some new stuff. So we'll just create an app here with a Zippy in it. And we'll start with our app, say app directive, Zippy, return restrict E for element, and then with a template of, we'll just say for now, div and hello world, just to make sure this is working. And we'll keep our console open in case I make any mistakes. So we have hello world working. Basically what we're going to do here is build a component that when you click on the title, it'll expand and show you the content. When you click on the title again, it'll collapse and hide the content. So inside of our Zippy component, we're also going to have some content. So we'll say this is the content because that's a great content. And we'll have a title that we pass in from an input, I guess. This is kind of like the Zippy component you'll see in the docs if this sounds familiar. So we'll say model title. And then the title in here will be model title. I guess we can do this is, we can also do some content in here. We'll say this is the model content. Model content. So if we look at it now, we'll have two fields, title, content. And they're not hooked up at all yet. So let's start working on that. So in here, the title is coming in through an attribute. So we can do the shortcut here of just doing a scope. And we're going to need to restrict the scope or isolate the scope anyway, since it's more of a component. And we'll say title is @, and then we can just wrap this with a div. Let's get fancy here. So we'll wrap this with a div, and this will be our title. So bind to title. That's going to be this incoming title from the scope. So this should say title, which is bound now. And actually, let's change this to, we'll even wrap this with something like a H3, give it more of a title-y effect. So I'm a title. Perfect. So now we have a title. We also have some content in here. And now what we're going to do is we're going to set up a click on the title. So I will say, let's do ng click here. And we'll say toggle content. So in our linking function, we can do, in the link function, we can do our scope, so toggle content. And this will be a function that will hide and show the content whenever we click on it. So we'll set up something called scope is content visible. Sure, that works for me. And we'll say scope is content visible equals the flip of it. So from here, we can just say in our content, so ng show is content visible. All right, let's see where we're at here. So this is a title. Click on this. It'll show and hide the content. But the content should really be coming from here, which is not happening. That's because we haven't set up transclusion. Because, again, transclusion is when you take the content of an element and yank it out and then put it back into somewhere else inside of your directive. So we'll say transclude is true, and then we can drop our transclusion into here, just ng transclude. And we don't need that hello world in there anymore. So from here, this is a title, this is content. Click on this, you'll say world, this is content. You can see it's bound right here. Looks like I left, there I left in world. And so there I left in content. So I can say the content is. Right, so title time, content time, click on the title. This, the content is content time, click on it again, hide, show, and content is bound, and title is bound. All right, so that's kind of the basics of a Zippy component. We used things like create an element, bringing in the title from the attribute here, transcluding the content, and then bringing that in through ng transclude right here. Let's look at this a bit cleaner. So this will look something more like this. And from here on out, that's pretty much all we have to do, is we just show and hide the content by when you click on it, toggle that flag right there, and you have yourself a Zippy. You could style it to make it look more like a Zippy, but I'm not going to worry about styling it for now. And is there anything else to show? One thing to mention is that because this is transcluded, this expression model content is being evaluated in the scope of its parent. So even though we've isolated the scope you would think, I shouldn't be able to access model content because I isolated the scope. It's important to note that content that's transcluded is actually evaluated in the parent scope. So this has access to this, and then it just gets brought in and evaluated and provided into there as the string. So that's pretty much it. Hopefully that makes sense. And we'll start building some more advanced components as we go along.